18. Hello and welcome to the CNBC TV18 special power talk. Special because the person who has graced us in our studios is someone who is one of the most powerful captains of Indian industry and someone who has seen many cycles of our economy. The boy from Bihar, who is now an international leader when it comes to natural resources, joining me now is Mr. Anil Agarwal, the chairman of Vedanta Resources, and of course, our very special guest today. Mr. Agarwal, from me and from Nigel, thank you very much for gracing us in our new studio. You are one of the biggest personalities to inaugurate the studio, as it were.
Now, from the bottom of my heart, CNBC is a very special.
Okay.
And really congratulations to the entire CNBC team and to the Rahul, how you people are growing and how you are making sure India grow. So I again wish each of every member of the CNBC all the best.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. Mm-hmm. From me and Nigel and the entire group. Well, first up, I mean, you know, the country today is in a bit of a crossroad. We have this very laudable goal of a $5 trillion economy in the next 5 years, and yet at the moment there are some signs of slowdown. So first up, what would you say should be the first agenda for the government to give a push to the economy?
We are not in crossroad, we are in a straight road.
Okay.
Very clear. Mr. Modi has a very clear vision and determination. Of course, whatever come on the way, we'll work out. You know, 1.4 billion people with subcontinent of Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Sikkim, Nepal.
Yes.
37 million people. Is almost 2 billion people.
Yes.
To 25% population.
Yes.
Of the world.
Yes.
And the presence of Mr. Modi, it has felt in the world that this is a very, very important country, and we are very, very, very proud. Everybody has his own way of looking and want to contribute in his own way. I'm very clear how the world has grown.
Mm.
The world has grown on the basis of two things. One is natural resource, and another is government has no business to be in a business.
Mm. Okay.
It's a two clear clear pillar.
Okay.
India going to be having $1 trillion of import. And whatever import they are going to do, we can produce everything in India.
Mm.
Whether it's oil, whether it's coal, whether it's gold, whether it's copper, uranium, anything you talk about, we can produce.
Okay, sir, you know, you've put two very important things on the table in terms of natural resources and the fact that it's not the business of government to be in business. You know, those were the questions Nigel and I had anyway prepared to ask you. So I'll take the first shot and then Nigel. You know, what would you advise the government in terms of the way it has handled natural resources? I mean, you have already contributed to this space. Where should the policy change?
Yeah, at the moment the policy is revenue minded.
Mm.
It has to come out of the revenue minded. It has to be production mind. You know, in line with the what world is do. And started trusting.
Mm.
Trusting the entrepreneur is the most important. The whole world goes on the self-certification.
Mm.
Even we pay the income tax, sales tax, all self-certification. Why do we need so much of pre-clearance?
Mm-hmm.
You know, once you say, most of the we are law-abiding people,
yes.
Forest clearance, anything clearance is not required.
Mm.
You know, we have a fantastic bureaucracy. Our ministers are really fired up.
Mm.
The way they want to deliver is amazing. The kind of dedication and the feeling they have. But when it's particulate on the notification, there is always a twist.
Okay.
And they have to be very careful that keep it simple.
Okay.
Keep it simple. But I'm coming to the point that the below the ground, above the ground, India has been able to take care of their food, which is a great achievement.
Yes, food security is a big achievement.
Mother Earth is saying, below the ground I have everything. Why you are importing?
Okay.
And we have entrepreneurs, and we have the best geology. This is the very fundamental. Keep the policy simple and make it as simple as possible. It will work.
Well, that's right, you know, Mr. Agarwal, and the government of India has been taking steps. They've opened up FDI in commercial mining as well. Now, that was a plea that came in from the industry for a long time. Your views on that, how positive is it? Because for all these years, we've only been looking at Coal India for all the coal we require.
So now commercial coal mining will interest you?
Can you believe that the entire India coal requirement is depend on the one company?
Okay.
You know, and so this is, you know, I'm talking in general, Coal India, Vedanta will come, Vedanta has a plan, but for India, the world will come.
Have you already applied, sir, because they were...
Yeah, we are all working, we are evaluating, but the entire, whether it's a gold, whether it's a copper, whether it's a coal, anything, iron ore, we have phenomenal reserve.
True.
And this will complete change our country, because we need money.
Yeah.
True.
We need money. So this is natural resource. I can go in as much as detail you want, but again and again I'm saying that keep the world norms. World does not give more than 20 to 30% contribution to the government.
Yes. Right.
And what happened? The government here tried to get 70-80%. Mine will open. Small mine will open.
Okay.
So that is the very, very important thing.
Okay. So the district mining fund, all those levies you think should be rationalized. There are too many levies on mining.
It should be world class.
Okay.
Whatever the world is happening, so billions of dollars is required.
We thought we have become world class in terms of the tax cuts that was announced by the government. What are your views? You think that's good enough?
The whole world has said, what government has done, you pick up any newspaper in the world, they have appreciated. And normally which take 3 to 4 years to come to this position, government was bold enough to do it in one shot, and that has definitely sent a very positive signal. And what we hear from the what government is contemplating, what that they're reducing, because salary people are very, very upset.
Yeah.
You know, it's very important that we should have to look at, and the kind of tax we have on salary people has to come down. And what we hear, the general income tax will also be reduced. The whole thing we are reducing. Where the money will come?
Okay.
The money will come from natural resource. Money will come when you have 30, 25 national bank. And then you have 50 public sector company. These are the company phenomenal. And if you can, if you do one by one, it will take 10 years. You have to come out one idea.
So you want an aggressive divestment?
Not aggressive. That government will not hold more than 50%. That itself will send a huge signal. That because anywhere when the government holds 50%, by and large the management, don't give this company to Anil Agarwal.
But actually the government has announced its intention to bring a stake down in public sector companies, non-bank public sector companies below 50. But there is one fear that they may do it through an offer for sale. And you know, HZL and BALCO, if they do by that route, would not that defeat the purpose?
No, see, when they start talking about BPCL, Container Corporation, debate will start.
Yes.
But when you say we are going to come down to 50% across, so that nobody will say no.
Right.
That will be the fundamental change. Then everything is in their hand. Even they run with the 50%, government interference will come down drastically.
Right.
There'll be independent board. There'll be independent CEO. You don't have to pay the salary what government decide.
Yeah.
The board can decide. There'll be no board influence director. You see L&T is running.
Yeah.
You see ITC is running. You see ICICI is running. You know, so why can't our company can run?
Okay.
So this is the whole idea. Out of that 50% when it comes, then they decide, some of the company, they want to divest. That's fine. But this one shot, I have a feeling the amount of money they will get.
Yeah.
It's going to be the billions of dollars, trillions of dollars money will come just making it up to 50%.
Right.
And that will open up the entire world.
Yeah.
Because the other side of the bridge,
yes,
two things are there. Huge pool of money.
Yeah.
And number two, huge talent.
Right. You know, Mr. Agarwal, just taking that point forward, in the past, you've always said your intent to go ahead and buy the stake in Hindustan Zinc. Now, we haven't heard about that for the last couple of years, but we understand that the government of India is bringing that back onto the table. 30% is what they have. Will you be interested?
I will be. But, you know, why to delay? 5 years you delay everything. You know, we have trying to prove as much as possible. Vedanta is one company. I really come from very humble background and always look at my India.
Yeah.
You know, it is never happened. This is the example I should not say from my mouth. Mm. But $35 billion I brought it FDI from outside, yes, and invested here. You know, I have, you will not believe, I have paid, it's hard to anybody to believe, we have paid in 6 years 2 lakh crore tax,
okay,
to the exchequer. Okay. You know, my IFC has done independent report and say Vedanta has 1.4% GDP of the country.
Okay.
My Tuticorin is top,
yeah.
Goa mining is top. You know, is the 30% residual share.
Yeah.
I don't want, but it is for me to move forward.
Yeah.
Let the business go on.
Yes.
Right.
Take the decision,
right,
because you also spending time. We also 5 years we are talking the same thing,
yes, right,
which is a very small issue.
Right.
Take your point, sir. Mm. I mean, quicker decision making,
yes,
and ease of doing business.
Yes.
After all, that is the mantra of the government. We have to take a commercial break, but we have lots more questions, sir, from this boy from Bihar who has betted big on Indian business, especially natural resources. What's the way forward for Vedanta Group itself? And his advice to the Indian government. All that in just a minute. Welcome back to this very special edition of Power Talk. Our guest today is, of course, one of the most powerful names in the field of natural resources, Chairman of Vedanta Resources, Anil Agarwal. Mr. Agarwal, since you have a global view, I wanted to know, how do you look at the global metal prices itself and refining margins? Where are we in the global cycle? Do you think this downturn will last, or do you think things can improve?
Definitely there is going to be correction. It can be 5-7% go down, but there is no new mines are coming. It's very difficult to open up a new mines. I don't think any big oil production is going to take place. So I'm quite bullish as far as these things are concerned. So far India, in China was pushing and consumption. I am very bullish on India.
Okay.
Very bullish on India. Mr. Modi's government, when they open up, people are saying, look at today. Don't look at today, but look at the span, how we are going to build the complete infrastructure of the countries, the entire metal demand. So I'm not bearish at all on the metal side.
Okay. So base metal prices, you believe, have bottomed out at current levels? Because in the last 1 year or so, so much of talk about this trade war between United States and China. Now the worst is behind us?
No, the trade between, they have different agenda. You know, and the country like are suffering. Today, if you look at what has happened last 2 years, 60% of the India production of aluminium has been dumped here.
Right.
$6 billion worth of aluminium being dumped because of the trade war between China and US.
Right.
So US is dumping all their scrap into India. Yeah. China is dumping their scrap into India. So these things are happening. We have to be careful.
So for our domestic metal industry, what would your request be to the government of India? As you said, aluminium is being dumped, and it's been dumped in for the last few years, and there's no slowing down out there.
So some tariff falls needed.
Yeah.
Yeah. But what I'm saying, it is a general If you see how America has come up, how China has come up, let's not look at individual. The government duty is to any industry start, keep watch.
Yeah.
I know, whether giving them a clearances, making sure they come into the production, yeah. if they have any trouble. This is what the pattern of America and the China. Each so if textile industry is there, which one has a half production, how can we make the full production,
yeah.
what government other problems are going on. So it is a government fundamental,
yeah.
whether it's aluminium industry, to make sure that our industry survive.
Sure.
And keep take the quick decision. What have the discrimination is killing in India.
Yeah.
You know, government company have access to the government and they can get anything done.
Mm-hmm.
We have to go to the government. The people think, are we favoring to the private people? Then we take the shelter
okay.
of some government company and take them in the front. So the file start written.
Okay.
So we have to rewrite our, you know, the how
the lack of faith in private sector is bad.
It's not like it's a culture.
Mm.
It's a culture. It's please see Discovery Channel when they say how America is built.
Mm.
They never say Mr. Lincoln. They never say any big politician name.
Yeah.
They talk about five industrialists.
Mm.
Yeah.
Rockefeller, yes. Wendell Waite. You know, Harrison Ford,
yes.
there's five people they talk about who built America.
Mm.
And all of them, biggest thing was, they have not given the legacy to their children.
Yep.
They're put in a corporation.
Yeah.
And most of the wealth they are given back to the society. India will happen the same thing.
Yeah. Mr. Agarwal, since you are the expert in resources, leave us with something that you would want the government to change on the mining and natural resources front. I mean, in Goa or in Tuticorin or generally in terms of, you know, the mining cesses that are levied.
Yeah, the two things, it include oil and gas.
Yeah, sure.
Which is very important. Very, very important. Oil and gas existing contract, scrap everything,
okay.
Make it self-declaration.
Okay.
Self-declaration, except environmental clearance.
Okay. Okay.
We have to protect our environment highest.
Mm.
So that government can look at. Apart from that, everything is self-certificate, whether taking permission from ONGC or anything will help.
Yeah.
Number two, on the mining side, most important thing is forest clearance.
Mm.
Forest clearance must be finished. You have people like Mr. Javadekar.
Mm.
He is the Krantikari.
Mm.
If he can't do it in his legacy to make sure these things come up without violating the rule of
the law of the land.
We have to protect our nature.
Mm.
And I can tell you today, it is amazing technology has come. We can make environment better by producing to in 60 days clearance of forest clearance.
Yeah.
Very, very important.
Okay.
And then no revenue minded. It has to be on the world, see the world.
On value added.
On the value added.
Right. You know, Mr. Agarwal, being a new father, I'm going to keep that advice in mind, you know, in terms of parenthood going ahead as well and encourage the children. So, thanks for that. But, you know, I wonder, you have never shied away from getting into a new business. Over all these years, there have been challenges, yet you went into steel. You know, besides that, you have expressed some intention or some kind of, you know, dream that you want to get into aviation as well. There was a bid for Jet Airways. Now, there is an Air India that's up for grabs. Will you be looking at it?
See, I have been approached by the government. I'm very pleased. They trust us.
Hmm.
I get a call. This is our sky. We can't go to Tom, Dick and Harry.
Hmm.
But, you know, for me, it's a billions of dollars.
Yeah.
I'm a man from Bihar, simple man. And when they say, we trust you.
Hmm.
Yeah.
That's a big thing for me. So this is anything, please be ready. You have proven in the past.
Yes.
You know.
So I you have, are looking at Air India.
No, I have no plan because I have never diverted myself in anything else.
Okay.
I have diverted in one company,
yeah.
which is I always has a vision on the electronic side.
Okay.
Because I promised the government that electronic is very important. Okay. We are going to import $250 billion of import, and which require major is glass.
Okay.
Glass.
So whether it's a computer glass,
yes.
whether it's a TV glass, whether it's cell glass, then you have the chips. all our glass. And we started that.
Okay.
Right. I'm very keen that we can do this so thousands of new industry can come in.
Okay.
Fair so enough. That we are doing, I have no intention. I will listen to the government. If there is anything I can be help and come out to put my time or effort, because any of the government asset is phenomenal.
Okay.
If you use them, if you can develop them well, it can create 3 times more productive.
True. Okay.
So including the people.
True. Okay. So for now, Air India is not on the table. What about the Nagarna steel plant? The government of India is talking about selling that big government-owned steel plant. 3 million tons, it's ready to sell today. Will you be interested, sir?
No, see, we can't talk piece by piece.
Yeah. Hmm.
We are talking the government has to look at the 50 company.
Yeah.
Let's look at, because there is no point getting into the controversy.
Okay. True.
Because in India, yeah. They are left-wing, they are right-wing, they are up-wing, they will start up. When we find that there is a range is there.
Yeah.
If the range is complete, I'll shoot.
Okay. Mr. Agarwal, let me scratch that point further. You said something about Vedanta Resources' contribution to the exchequer and to the GDP. Is this an independent report that you are quoting?
Yes, there are two independent reports. You know, as you talk about philanthropy, this is also, I feel, that you're contributing 2 lakh crore in the entire Modi ji time.
Okay. In the last 6 years, Vedanta Resources' contribution to the exchequer.
Tax.
Yes.
2 lakh crore, which okay. never happened in the past
okay.
to anybody. I feel very, very, very good. And I can tell you, if they would have given me the free hand to bring my production of oil and gas or my other natural resources, I could have doubled that.
Okay.
And so you can imagine the potential of India. I'm the smallest country in this country.
Okay.
It's and tip of the iceberg. If they have the similar thing, you know, today they are talking about, I really feel that the tourism tax, individual tax should slash down and they can get huge money
returns
from the natural resource.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What about the contribution to GDP? Even that is an independent
IFC, authority. IFC, as you know, very international.
Yeah.
They have done the independent survey of Vedanta in India, and they find the contribution of Vedanta 1.4%
okay.
GDP.
Okay, well, that's big. May our strength increase.
And this is the 2 lakh crore, $41.7 billion has been paid by Vedanta to the exchequer.
Okay, congratulations.
So everybody tells me about the philanthropy. This is also greatest philanthropy.
I agree, sir. Yeah.
And I only looking, leave it to me. This is the smallest company, where tip of the iceberg, what a potential India has.
Mr. Agarwal, it's a pleasure having you with us in our news studios. Thank you very much for joining us. Some very important takeaways. Don't ever compromise on environment and forest clearance, but it's important to make them time-bound and quick. And more importantly, the key takeaway is when you are looking at taxing natural resources, don't tax them, when they are pulled out of the ground, but tax them on value added so that people add to productivity. Mr. Agarwal, thank you very much for joining us in this very special chat.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Mr. Agarwal.